Mentors English Express and I'm Sudha Oberoi. Today I'm going to teach the students of class 12 chapter number 1, the last lesson from their English book Flamingo, which is written by Alphonse Daudet. Now this chapter is about the narration of French-Prussian War when Germany occupied two French districts, Alsace and Lorraine, and imposed German language on the French people. Now this chapter discusses the importance of native language. Let us see the importance. It helps to express spontaneously. We can express spontaneously in our native language. It helps to unite the people also, and they have a sense of belonging to each other. They share each other's joys and sorrows, and they unanimously take decisions. It gives identity to a nation. Like in France, people speak French, so they are called French people. In Germany, people speak German language, they are called German people. And in India, we speak Hindi, we are called Indians. It helps to preserve the culture also. Now, lack of command of native language makes the people of the country weak. And the powerful nations, they overtake them and they make them their slaves. So, this chapter discusses the importance of native language. We have two main characters in this story, in this chapter. One is teacher M. Hamel, who is French teacher and teaching them French for last 40 years. Next is Franz, he is a student, sometimes very careless also. Now I am going to tell you the important points which are going to summarize the complete chapter. These points are going to help you answer one mark question also and multiple choice questions also, and you will become confident. Now let us see the important points of the chapter. Now Franz is very scared to go to school. Why? Because he is unprepared with the participles. He has not prepared the participles. His teacher is going to ask him questions on it and he is not prepared. So he dreads his punishment. He doesn't want to go to school. So he is getting distracted on the way to school. Now what are the distractions? The distractions are, the weather is very pleasant. He wants to enjoy the pleasant weather. He wants to enjoy the twittering of the birds also. And he wants to watch the Prussian soldiers drilling near the sawmill. So these are the distractions. Then finally he decides to go to school. Now on the way he comes across the bulletin board. Now bulletin board is a public board where all sorts of information is given. Now on this bulletin board, sometimes good news is there and sometimes bad news is there. He tries to look at the bulletin board, but because there is a big crowd, he is not able to see it. And finally he reaches his school. So on reaching school, he is quite surprised. Now this is very important why he is surprised. Because unlike other days, there was complete silence in the class. Nobody was roaming here and there. Everybody was seated. There was complete discipline. Teacher was wearing the best attire. Attire is dress. Now teacher was dressed in his best suit, and then village elders were sitting at the back of the class with primer in their hands. This is also very, very important that on that day villagers were sitting in the end of the class. So that day there was complete silence in the class. Everybody was concentrating. Teacher was wearing the best attire. He was not wrapping his scale also, ruler also. And the village elders were sitting at the back of the class. Now the teacher disclosed the information on the bulletin board and told them that from next day, German would be taught in Alsace and Lorraine schools. So he is disappointed and shocked.
Franz is shocked to hear the information,
which was displayed on the bulletin board, and he starts repenting. Repenting for not paying concentration in the class. He had a very lackadaisical attitude towards learning. He never concentrated in the class, so he did not have a command over the language. But today, at this very moment, his perspective towards school changed. Perspective is outlook. Now, what are the changes? The changes are that he hated the books, but today he started loving the books. He developed respect for his teacher also, and he tried to concentrate in the class. So, all of a sudden, there is a change in the heart of Franz. Now, teacher also, who is very sad and upset because from the next day, German language would be taught, and this is the last chapter for him, he glorifies the French language. Now, he is glorifying the language because he wants them to learn the language. He wants them to have a command over their language. He tells them that this language is the most beautiful and logical language of the world. And he requests them to guard their language. Now, after this, he asks participles from France, but he is not able to answer and he doesn't scold him at all. But he gives him an advice. What is the advice? That we should not postpone things for tomorrow, because tomorrow never comes. So we must do everything on time. Here also, they had a lackadaisical attitude towards learning, and today when there is the last lesson, they do not have the command over the native language. Now he tells them to have a command over the language, as it is a key to prison of slavery. This is also very, very important. Now, key means solutions. When will they get the solutions? When they are going to unite. And when they are going to unite, they will be able to express their problems. They will take out the solutions unanimously, because unity is strength. And by uniting, they can revolt against the Germans also, and they can restore their freedom. The teacher is upset and he too has regrets. Now he blames himself for sending the children to water the plants or giving them holiday when he wanted to go for fishing. This he did sometimes. When he wanted to go for fishing, he either sent them to water the plants or he gave them a holiday. He blamed the parents also for not sending their children to school, instead sending them to field to work. And he blamed the children also, because children are also most important component of this part, because they did not concentrate on the lessons, and that is why they did not have a command over the language. Now teacher is overpowered with the emotions for not doing his duty properly. Just then the church bell strikes and the teacher M. Himmel writes on the board, "Vive la France," which means long live France. So children, it is very necessary to have a command over the native language and be proud of it. I hope the chapter is very clear to you. Here are very short questions which are going to further give you a command over the chapter. Question 1 is, what was the temptation for France? It was pleasant weather, twittering of birds and Prussian soldiers drilling. Now good and bad news came from the bulletin board. Now you could also be asked, why was he running away from school? Because he was unprepared with the participles. Now who asked Franz not to hurry to school? You have to read the question very carefully and then answer. Not to hurry to school. So when he was hurrying to school, he met blacksmith watcher who told him not to hurry for school as there was sufficient time. Now teacher was going to question Franz on participles. Now what is unusual about M. Himmel's dress? He wore the dress he usually wore on the prize days. Now how did Franz behave on that day in the class? Now on particular day, that particular day, he developed liking for the books, respect for the teacher, and tried to concentrate in the class. So he was very remorseful for not concentrating in the past in the class. Now this is very important question. From where did the orders come? Now orders had come from Berlin. They had not come from the bulletin board. They had come from the Berlin and they were written on the bulletin board. For how long M. Himmel had served school? He served for 40 years. Now what did the teacher blame parents for? For sending children to work on fields. Why did the old villagers come to school that day? As you know, they were sitting at the back of the class. They had come to express their gratitude to the teacher who was so devoted. Now, which language would the student study from next day? It is German. Then, what is the moral of the story? It is not to put things away for next day, as tomorrow never comes. Why does the author urge the reader to respect native language? Because it is the key to freedom. Now, you could even be asked, how was M. Hamel feeling on the last day? So, M. Hamel was feeling sad on the last day. Why did he give children a holiday? Because he wanted to go for fishing. Then he gave holiday to the children. What is primer? Primer is a book for beginners. Now, why didn't the teacher scold Franz on that day? Because he was sad and sentimental and he wanted them to develop love for their language. So, he is a true patriot. Here are a few short answer questions, important ones which we expect to come in the board exams. These are to be answered in 30-40 words. I'm going to give you the value points. You can elaborate them on your own. What a thunderclap these words were for me. What were the words? In this question, you have to answer what were the words that shocked the narrator. So, now what were the words? The words were that it was their last lesson in French and the new German teacher will take the charge from the next day. Now, these were shocking because this was an unexpected news for them. So, they all were full of remorse. This is very important questions. Question number two. What did M. Hamel tell them about the French language? Now, he told them that it was the most beautiful, clearest and logical language of the world. And they must guard it. You must mention this also, that they must guard it. Question number three is, how did the teacher say farewell to his students? You have to give answer to the question how. Now, how means he was very sad, but in a very dignified way, he replied to the student. He bid farewell to the student. Because he is a very devoted teacher, he did his duty with devotion. He urged them to keep the language alive and close to their hearts. And he was able to arouse love for the language. Another very important question is, what did he write on the board before dismissing the class? Now, M. Hamel is a devoted teacher. He was very sad. So, he wrote on the board, Vive la France, which means long live France. This shows his deep-rooted love for his motherland. There is another very important question which we expect in the board exam. What was unusual about M. Hamel's dress on his last day? Now, on his last day, he was dressed in a very dignified, formal way. He was wearing a beautiful green coat, frilled shirt, and an embroidered silk hat. He usually wore on prize days. So, these are very important questions. You can elaborate them on your own. Here are long answer questions to be answered in 120-150 words. Here also I am going to give you value points. You can elaborate those by value points on your own. Your question number one is, the ban on teaching French strengthened their resolve to learn the French language. Give evidence to prove your answer. Now you have to give the evidence from the story that shows that their resolve to learn French was strengthened. Now, this story clearly brings out the resolve of the French to hold fast to their language and have pride in it. Now, the points which strengthen them, your evidences are, they made them determined to respect, learn. What made them? The order from Berlin. Made them determined to respect and learn their language. Now, on that day, there was absolute silence in the class. And children were sitting in their own seats. Franz, who hated books, started liking his books. He developed a respect for his teacher and he concentrated in the class. Important thing which you have to mention is that village elders were sitting in the class at the end with the primers in their hand. And another very important point which you should mention is that no one was distracted by beetles and pigeons. Teacher was dressed in his best attire, and on his last day, though he was sad, he was doing his duty. He requested them to safeguard their language. So these are the value points which you can elaborate. Now another important question is, justify the title, The Last Lesson. Sometimes you get questions like this. Now the title is also very significant because it conveys the central theme. It highlights that sometimes most precious things are taken for granted by us. For example, the people of German never realized the importance of native language because children were irregular to school and they did not concentrate in the class. But the order from Berlin that from next day German would be taught came as a bolt from blue. Bolt from blue means it was very, very shocking news for them. They had not expected this at all. And they thronged towards the school. And village elders also sat at the end of the class. So the title is absolutely apt because it revolves around the last lesson in French. Now suppose you get a question to give a character sketch of France, who is a very important character. Now France is carefree. He did not concentrate in the class on his studies, but he dreaded his teacher's punishment when he went unprepared to school. After the order from Berlin, his outlook completely changes. He becomes repentant. This shows that he has become wise. He starts liking his books. He develops respect for his teacher. He concentrates in the class. So overall, he realizes that nothing is impossible if one is determined to achieve it. So wisdom dawns upon him in the end. Now another important question is character sketch of M. Hamel, who is the central character of the story. He is very devoted. For last 40 years, he has been teaching French to the French people. He has got profound respect for mother tongue. And this shows because he becomes shattered when he listens to the news that it was his last French lesson on that day. He is a great patriot as he succeeds in igniting love for mother tongue by glorifying the language. He is also very honest. He blames himself for giving them holiday when he wanted to go for fishing. So in the end, he is overpowered with emotion when he writes, "Long live France." So these are the value points you can elaborate. Children, I hope the chapter last lesson is clear to you. And now you will be able to do one mark questions, MCQs, short answer questions or long answer questions confidently. You can download the complete text of this video from my Facebook page, the link of which is given below. Children, if you have enjoyed this video, like, share and subscribe it. You can also post your comments in the comments box below. Thank you.